हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू अवर चैनल ब्रेन अलाइव। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस इनपुट एंड आउटपुट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ कॉमन बेस कॉन्फ़िगरेशन। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल डिस्कस इनपुट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स। इनपुट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स इज द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन इनपुट करंट दैट इज IE एंड इनपुट वोल्टेज दैट इज VEB एट ए कॉन्स्टेंट कलेक्टर बेस वोल्टेज। दिस इज द सर्किट डायग्राम ऑफ कॉमन बेस कॉन्फ़िगरेशन। इन दिस वी विल फॉरवर्ड बायस एमीटर एंड बेस जंक्शन एंड रिवर्स बायस कलेक्टर बेस जंक्शन। दिस वोल्टेज बिटवीन कलेक्टर एंड बेस इज कॉल्ड VCB एंड द वोल्टेज बिटवीन एमीटर एंड बेस इज नोन एज VEB। नाउ टू ड्रॉ द इनपुट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ दिस कॉमन बेस कॉन्फिग्रेशन, वी विल फिक्स द वैल्यू ऑफ VB एंड चेंज द वैल्यू ऑफ VB एंड नोट द वैल्यू ऑफ करंट IE। Let first we fix the value of VCB equals to 0 and change the value of VEB and note the value of IE. For some more values of VB, we will note the value of IE at this fixed voltage equals to 0. Then we draw the curve using this data. We will get this curve. Now we will fix the value of VCB equals to 5 volt and change the value of VB and note the value of IE. Then we will get this curve. And when we fix the value of VCB equals to 10 volt, then and change the value of VEB and note the value of IE, we will get this curve. By observing these curves, we can see clearly when the value of VEB is less than cut-in voltage, offset voltage, or we can say threshold voltage, these both are same, then IE is very small. But when we increase after this, when we increase the value of VB or very slightly, there is a large increase in the current IE. When there is a rapid increase in IE with a small change in VEB, this shows that the input resistance is very less because this junction is forward bias. This also shows that the input resistance is very less. By observing the curve, we can see when we increase the fixed value of VCB, there is a shift of curves towards the left side and also the IE increases. This is due to the fact when we increase VCB, the reverse biasing is increased and the width of depletion region at collector junction increases. So the increase of depletion region width reduces the actual width of the base region. So less voltage of VB is required for the flow of current IE. Now we will draw the output characteristics of common base configuration. Output characteristics establish a relationship between output voltage and output current at a fixed value of IE. First of all, to draw the characteristics, first of all, we fix the value of IE equals to 0 using this battery. Then we will change the value of VCB and note the value of current. At this fixed voltage, we will take 3 or 4 readings and we will draw the graph. We will get this graph at IE equals to 0. Then we will change the value of this IE and fix this IE equals to 2 milliampere. And then change the value of this and note the value of current. For some readings, we will get this curve. And then we can get these curves by fixing the value of IE at 4 milliampere, 6 milliampere and 8 milliampere. We'll get these curves. Now we will analyze the output characteristics using this graph. This is active region from this curve to this curve. This is active region. And in active region, emitter base junction is forward bias and collector base junction is reversed bias. We can see here when we increase the voltage, there is no change in IC. It is almost constant. IE equals to 2 milliampere. It is also almost equals to 2 milliampere. So we see that IC depends upon IE. It does not depend upon VCB. Through equation also, for common base configuration, IC equals to alpha I, and alpha is the current amplification factor for common base configuration. We know IE is almost equal to IC because the value of IB is very less. So alpha is almost equals to 1. That's why the IC is almost equals to IE. In active region, the transistor is used as an amplifier because IC is proportional to IE. The region below this curve means when IE equals to 0 milliampere. The region below this curve is cutoff region. In this region, both the junction emitter based junction and also the collector based junction are reversed bias. So in this case, even both the junction are reversed bias, the transistor is in cutoff region, means no current is flowing in the circuit. Only the current that flows in the circuit is leakage current. We can understand through this equation. The total current equation of common base configuration is this one, IC equals to alpha IE plus ICBO. This ICBO is the leakage current. When collector to base current, this current is collector to base current when emitter is open, means there is no current in the input side. So when there is no current in the input side, means IE equals to 0. So IC will be equals to ICBO. So when IE equals to 0, there is a leakage current that is equals to, this is leakage current from this. So this is leakage current from this point to this point. So this is the cutoff region when only ICBO flows. This is leakage current. Now this region towards the left of active region, this region is known as saturation region. In this region, we can see the VCB is negative, means in this case, this terminal becomes negative with respect to the common terminal. When this terminal becomes negative, so this collector and base junction will be forward bias. So in saturation region, emitter base junction and also the collector base junction both are forward bias. So there is a sudden increase in the current. We can see here, even when the VCB is equals to 0, there is a flow of current IC in the circuit. When VCB equals to 0 and we have fixed the IE equals to 2 milliampere, the current equals to 2, almost equals to 2 milliampere also flows in the circuit. By finding the slope of these curves, we can find the output resistance of common base configuration, that is change in VCB upon change in IC at a constant current IE. So this is the whole analysis of the output characteristics of common base configuration. I hope now you are able to explain the characteristics of common base configuration. If you like the video, please hit the like button and subscribe the channel. Thanks for watching the video.